Top of the time zone to you. This is Freddie J with Freddie J Sports, and we're here for the finals of the Kapalua Championships here at the Kapalua Plantation. Currently, we are 13 under for the round with a big lead. Let's go ahead and get on to it.
Welcome to the Kapalua Resort, where the trade winds and dramatic elevation changes will be a constant challenge. Hello, everyone. I'm Gary McCord for EA Sports. My partner, David Faraday, is down on the first tee, ready to help call today's action.
Totally forgot to change shirts, but don't care. We're cooking.
Welcome to the final round of this PGA Tour event at Kapalua. You're in the lead by 7 strokes going to the final round. Stay away from bogeys and you will win this tournament.
And that's the bottom line. She said so.
Nicely played on this one.
Crowd going wild. We've been dominating for so long. This one's going to get a nice little roll too. 293.
Take some advice. Go with 8.
8, you sure? Well, too bad I don't have an 8. That one's gonna just barely creep on the green. Put it within 10 feet. This one's a nice little turner. No Timmy. In there.
14 under for the tournament.
Furyk Funk for Plank. Not really moving much on the scorecard.
Drift is a downwind par 3 to a large green angled from left to right. The tilt of the green plus the direction and force of the wind favor shots that fade and are played with finesse. This one will end up on the putting surface.
Ooh, that's a little bit too far. But it did the job. Did the job well. All right, this is 8 inches, a foot. That should be good aim.
This one could drop.
Looking good. Back to back.
For the championship.
All right, looks like someone's moving up.
Easterly is a hole of medium length made longer by playing directly into the trade winds. The fairway bends slightly to the right, past a cluster of bunkers leading to a plateaued green which slopes from right to left. It is guarded on the wings by 2 predominant bunkers.
All right.
Maximizing the power with this swing.
Might be going a little bit too much to the left, but we're still on.
Flagstick locations will never be more challenging than they are today.
I think that should be good.
That's got a chance right at the flagstick.
Oh my goodness, we are hunting today. What are you measuring that for? Just tap the thing in.
16 under par for the tournament.
3 in a row. We're running away with this thing for real, for real.
The high road.
Sorry, but we're on a run right now.
further than usual.
That natural draw we got with the thumbstick is gonna come into factor soon. 268 off the tee.
What do you see? Maybe just about 110 yards to the flag. And this will end up on the putting surface.
I wanted to go a little bit closer than that, man. We've just been on it. It's like we know this course.
Four under par today.
Jim Furyk, 8 strokes back now. He needs to get a move on.
Cape slopes left to right all the way. This sucker's gonna fly.
That is a big hit right there. Feels a bit weak, honestly.
200 to the stick.
We don't need all that. Oh, look at that. Look at that. You can stop. Stop right there. 2 feet to the pin. My goodness.
Going for eagle in this par five.
The crowd is going bonkers.
18 under par for the tournament.
Running away now. And now Jim Furyk just lost a stroke, currently through 11 right now. Verplank is through 8.
Cross and down. A spectacular, mysterious par 4 with alternate routes to the green. Play the ideal tee shot dangerously, powerfully, and accurately across the cliffs to the right side of the fairway where the green may be adequately viewed.
I did not like that one. I did not like that one either.
This should play nicely.
I just wanted to roll down the hill. We'll get there one day.
David Faraday, all downhill from here. We could bump and chase it down or loft it up high and try and stick it. Player's choice on this one.
I ain't touching it. I had to.
Miracles do occur.
6 feet to the pin. We've been on it like a bonnet today.
This for 6 birdies in a row.
This is for the Birdie Street trophy ball, too. And we got it.
The birdies are flying all over the place today. That's 6 in a row and definitely worth a trophy ball.
Amazing.
Molokai is the second of a 3-long downhill downwind par 4s. The expansive fairway angling from left to right is inviting, as is the large undulating green. The green, with its bunkering, encourages running approaches.
We're just eating these up right now.
This looks good. Should be safely on the green.
Stop. That is 17 feet.
Seven straight birdies. If it goes in.
Oh my goodness. We are just on fire right now.
Gorge is a middle iron par 3 playing across a native canyon to a receptive green. The green, which slopes back to front and right to left, was built to hold and nurse the ball to the left.
We have been on it today.
This is headed for the green.
And this one's going to get a nice little roll, too.
This would be an amazing 8 straight birdies.
This one's going to be a little bit tougher. But it can be done. Got it! This has been an amazing round of golf so far. We're not even looking at the leaderboard.
The tee shot must be solidly played into the fairway to allow the second to carry a large valley in the fairway crossing. Shots failing to carry the valley leave blind approaches. Those carrying the valley will position the players for a short iron or pitch approach shot to a plateaued green guarded by bunkers on the right. Here, par is coveted.
This is the one hole. The one hole.
This tee shot should give him a lot of confidence.
This is the one hole where I've been struggling with. And now we have a chance.
Oh, this one's more than 240 yards, just miles from the hole.
That's okay.
For trouble, you've come to the right place. Might as well call the Auto Club to get us out of here.
That is a good recovery.
This for a 9th consecutive birdie.
In there.
For the tournament.
Each one of these putts gets scarier and scarier. But check this. We just birdied, or better, the entire front 9. We are running away with this.
The 10th is a relatively short par 4, made substantially longer by playing into the wind and slightly uphill. The ample fairway, tilting dramatically from right to left, invites controlled draws. The green rewards low driving shots into the wind and running approaches.
$295.
What a shot, David.
5 feet.
David?
Oh my.
Put this putt just outside the hole?
Yeah, maybe right on the lip. Not much in it.
Oh, you're gonna hate this one. This is gonna test you. He got it! Bro is on ice. There's ice in his veins. It's not even that warm. What is going on? It's crazy.
The last par three of the course demands and rewards thoughtful finesse. A shot flown directly into the back left pin will not likely be tried more than once.
All right.
All right, let's go while we're young here, hey?
This looks good. Should be safely on the green.
Oh my goodness.
11 birdies in a row.
This is going to definitely test us. And this is the longest putt. Will the streak end, or we're gonna see something beautiful? Oh my goodness. The streak is over.
24 under for the championship.
That was a tough pill to swallow. Our first par.
Lanai is a statistically long par 4. Transformed into a drive and pitch hole by the prevailing wind. An accurate carrying tee shot to the hilltop leaves a short pitch to a small concave green with steep surrounding slopes. He's gonna like this tee shot.
That one is gone.
David Faraday.
I've worked this one off. 140 yards to the hole.
Should have a good chance from there.
Why is it moving that far?
Ooh, a very makeable, gentle putt. Just goes slightly leftish at the end. Come on, baby!
There we go. We're back to our birdie ways. Yeah, nobody's catching me. You're fighting for Jim Furyk's fighting for second now.
Low boring tee shots and approaches favoring the right side of the fairway are necessary to reach this deep and deceptive green in regulation. Putts numbering three or more will also be commonplace given the green size, slope, and the wind's effects.
Having a little zest here, Harry. Is a pine cone any relation to a pineapple? Make for an interesting fruit salad.
The thoughts you think.
Right on target.
For two straight birdies.
Birdie Buster ball. We got two trophy balls.
And for that, we present you with the Birdie Buster trophy ball.
My goodness, 26 under for the tournament.
The course's smallest green perched atop another plateau. The ever-present winds and an expansive array of fairway bunkers lying in wait test both tee shots and approaches. What this hole may lack in length, it more than compensates for in personality.
Adding as much power as possible here, David.
I wouldn't be surprised if this rolls too much to the left, but that's going to be safe. Don't worry, we'll get him next time. Aw, man.
This will make it three straight birdies.
Wow.
13 under par on today's round.
That's only our second par of the round.
Switchback, a double dogleg par 5, showing not bunkers but natural character. Strongly defined by its slopes, the crossing winds, and another native canyon that borders the tee shot on the right and the left of the screen. Shots played more closely along these dangerous borders will afford opportunity for birdies.
Oh yeah, indeed. 286.
Back now. Play here is for the green.
Take the high road and I'll take the low road and I'll be at the hole before you.
Oh, God.
As much as I would love to make this shot, I'm... My goodness. Three holes to go.
Arena is a strategic hole of merit. Tee shots played powerfully and accurately over the bunkers afford the best angle of attack to the pin. The pin is best approached from the right side of the fairway, an area most dangerous to long drivers.
Shouldn't be a problem for me, though.
This is the way to keep the ball in play.
.288.
Uphill here, so it's going to come in a little flatter. Hard to tell how it's going to release.
Good luck.
Should be happy with this approach.
And I'll be happy if it's a little bit closer.
Well, it's okay. Not brilliant, but okay. At least we're dancing.
I like these reeds, though.
This looks really good.
Oh!
under par for the tournament.
Only allowing 3 pars today.
The tee shot, preferably a high soaring draw, plays to a wide collecting fairway sloping right to left. Approach shots are played with anything from middle irons to fairway woods. A large yet subtle green beckons and accepts the long running approach.
He drilled this tee shot right where he wanted it.
And that one's going to be good. 310.
David, what do you have?
Well, about 250. This is a tough decision. Kind of 50-50 whether you go for this one or not.
Got no choice.
It'll be on the green. That's about all you could say about this shot.
It was on the green. Oh my goodness. If this one happens to drain in, there is no way. Keep going. Keep going. Go. Oh my goodness.
I don't believe it.
What? This has been insane. Look at that. Never in your life have you seen something like that.
Home, the hole around which the rest of the course was formulated. The large receptive fairway and green are difficult to judge owing to the vast panoramas and the scale of the background. Here, the scale and drama are uncommon. The challenge is within reason, while the surrounding beauty is unparalleled.
Birdie or better on this hole, and you'll hold the record for most birdies in a round.
All right, let's eat.
He just made a statement with that swing.
I needed this one to be long. .341.
Playing a 3-wood here's a good idea. That's the driver.
That is running real good.
Yeah, 2-foot would be quite an achievement from this position.
43 feet. This is for eagle. This is for the win, too. And that is looking nice. Oh my goodness, this is probably the best look we're gonna have. For the win.
Great shot.
Man. That's going to be a good 2 feet.
Right here.
It's already going to end it. We destroyed the field. Rookie of the year right here. Your champion.
Do you give to the best golfers in the game? Why, a trophy ball, of course.
Unbelievable.
And just because I'm a nice guy, I've got a trophy ball for you.
That's 2 trophy balls.
You've just beaten Tiger's record of 13 under par for a single round. There's a trophy for that one.
Crushed. That's like 5 trophy balls for this round. That's insane. And I've earned another part of my tour card.
Congratulations on your first tour.
Another tour.
Not only do we have a gigantic first place check for you, but you've also earned a very small trophy ball.
Destroyed most birdies in a round. Most fairways hit. Most greens in regulation. Lowest round of 57. And I've unlocked Wallaby Creep. Pay to the order of $350,000 to me, Freddy, the winner of the Kapalua Championships. Thank you very much. I might go ahead and buy me some clubs now. Look at that. Oh, looks like Furyk choked. Look at all that money. That's kind of when I want to go golfing in real life.
Good on you, mate. I'm Adam Scott, and you've just won your first PGA Tour event.
Aw, thanks. Aw, man. What a run. That was just beautiful. Like, plain and simple. That was probably one of the greatest videos y'all gonna ever see right here. I feel like I should have got more than that, but... Oh! Adidas has noticed me and wants to give me a signing bonus. Oh yeah. Well, this is gonna do it for me. Thank you so much. If you all like this kind of content, make sure you like, comment, and subscribe to Freddy J Sports here on YouTube. Appreciate y'all for coming out. My goodness, that was amazing. Simply amazing. Coming up next time for the season, we're going to be playing the TPC of Scottsdale Open. So make sure y'all tune for that. And as always, I'm Freddy J. Y'all have a good day and a better tomorrow. Until next time, we'll see ya.